Hi guys, this is Prashit Oakley back with another unplanned yet very demanded video. From the last couple of weeks, I've been uploading few pictures on my Instagram stories about Ross. And after seeing the stories, my Instagram DM were flooded with one common cloud of confusion. What is Ross? How Ross works? How can I learn Ross? Where is it used?
Ross.
I tried answering them all, but the flow of questions never stopped. So here I am answering all your questions. Before getting into this video, don't forget to give a thumbs up to this video if you find this useful. Also, don't forget to subscribe to my channel as it helps me keep making such videos. So let's get started with the first question. What is ROS? ROS stands for Robot Operating System. But don't misunderstand it with the operating system of your computer like Windows, Linux or macOS. It is an operating system specifically made for a robot which runs on an existing operating system such as Ubuntu. Then why is it called an operating system and not a software or a piece of code? To answer that question, let's first understand what is the difference between a piece of code and an operating system. Let's take a scenario where two people, Chandler and Joey, have the same Windows laptop and have downloaded the same code to make a line following robot. Now say, both of them want to add an obstacle avoidance as a feature to their robot. They both search over the internet and find the same approach. Now, when Chandler uses this same solution onto his robot works perfectly. While when Joey uses the same code on the same type of robot, it doesn't work just because of some driver issues over the software or over his operating system. Now just imagine both of them having same problem in their operating system, which is pretty common. Now, can they Google the problem and try different solutions, or should they simply update or patch their OS with the trusted Microsoft update, which solves all the problems commonly on their operating system? Well, everyone prefers updating. This is the exact difference between running a piece of code on your robot and ROS. A piece of code doesn't provide you flexibility to add multiple things to it while assuring it will work perfectly. While ROS provides you an open source platform with a large community and numerous frameworks and libraries to help you create your own robot according to your needs. And as the ROS documentation says, it provides all the necessary devices, drivers, visualizers, message parsers, and robust package management system to help you create your own application. Well, I like to consider ROS as a Subway store where you can choose your own ingredients to make your own sandwich, which in our case is our robot. Just as in Subway, you can add your own ingredients, be it common combinations like onions and mayonnaise, or weird combinations like pineapples and chicken. No one will judge you. ROS gives you the freedom to use your own choice of hardware, let's say any hobby servo motors, and your choice of software, which might even be the one ABB themselves use for their industrial robot. And hey look, that works wonders for you, just like your extraordinary sandwich. All these individual ingredients in ROS are called as nodes. There are a large number of nodes available in ROS which come from a variety of sources ranging from individual developers to large-scale robotic companies. So as we now know what ROS is, let's see how does ROS works. So we know that ROS has many individual nodes. But these nodes are like kindergarten kids who might just run away in the absence of a teacher. So to manage all the nodes, there is a ROS master. It connects all the nodes as well as set communication between them. In this example, we have two nodes which are connected, or we say registered, to a ROS master. Now for these nodes to talk to each other, we have something called as topic. So node 1 publishes its message to the topic, while node 2 subscribes to the same topic to get messages. So with multiple such nodes and their topic together, we can create our robot. Also, because of having separate nodes for separate functionalities, it becomes very easy to debug any problem or add a new feature with a new node anytime. Say for example, you have made a fully functional robot arm, and just then you find a guy from USA who has made an autonomous object detecting vehicle. Now you want to add the object detection module to your robotic arm as well. To get this done, all you need to do is find a node that is responsible for object detection functionality in his project and merge it with your ROS master. And see, now you have a robot arm that can detect objects as well. So now as you know what ROS is and how does it work, you might be wondering, where is ROS master? Or we say, who uses ROS? So you must have seen videos of dog-like robots like these, moving and jumping around, Par and robotic exhibitions. With this and multiple such robots are made on ROS with a motive to simplify human life and be a good companion.
Also, multiple billion-dollar companies uses ROS in almost all of their robotic and industrial automation products and research for a rapid and inexpensive prototyping. So just like Arduino is the go-to platform for hobbies, ROS is the go-to industry standard for robotic process and industrial automation. And that is why I feel every robotic engineer should consider learning it.
By this time you must be wondering, if ROS is such a useful and wonderful platform, why doesn't everybody know about it? Well, I will leave that question up to you. So guys, I'm not an expert in ROS, but I've been working on it quite for a while now. So I've tried my best to explain what is ROS in as simple words as I can. So if I have said anything wrong or I have missed out on any point, please do let me know in the comment section below. Also, if you find this video useful, don't forget to give a thumbs up and share it with your friends so even they know about ROS. Also, after watching this video, if you wish to dive more further into learning ROS, don't worry, I've got you covered. I'll be uploading new videos on ROS tutorials every week, focusing on more practical aspect of ROS and building your own robot with ROS. So if you want to get notified whenever I put my next video, don't forget to subscribe to my channel and ring the bell icon. That will motivate me a lot to make more such videos. Thank you for watching. Peace.